friends. It's my privilege to be able to stand up here. If you may say a few words about Miss Faye. She was a faithful mother, as you know, faithful wife, faithful grandmother, great-grandmother, a faithful friend, a faithful family member, and she was a faithful lady to this church. She was a faithful member of this church. Spent many a day playing organ over there, even though she didn't feel like it. She'd come in and she'd play it. I want to read you a few words of Ecclesiastes. It says, to everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant, a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. You know, Ecclesiastes right there goes back and forth between bitterness and sweet. Last Sunday and today is both of those things. It's bitter because we have to say temporarily goodbye to the presence of one that we loved. The presence won't be there anymore as far as the physical being able to talk to him and to touch him. Them to hold you and things like that. And that's bitter. That's hard. But the sweet part of it is that we know by her profession of faith in Jesus Christ and the way that she lived her life that she's okay. And she's in a far better place than we are. She's enjoying all the promises, all the things that we can pull out of this Bible, and I could read for quite a while if I'm not going to do it. Of all the things that heaven says that you and I will enjoy no more pain, no more sorrows, all those things pass away. So as we speak today, have comfort in knowing that we can have peace and we can have joy because we know that she knew where she's at. Let's pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, as we go through this service this morning, Lord, we do praise you that we can stand up today, and even though it's hard, and even though it's bitter, and even though that we're going to miss this faith, Lord, we have the comfort and we have the assurance that she's with you. And Lord, we're thankful for that. Lord, I ask that you'll bless each one that's here. I pray, my Father, that you'll give them the peace and understanding, my Lord, that can only come from you. And Lord, we're thankful for this family. I ask that you'll bless them. We ask all these things in Jesus' name. Thank you. sitting there thinking, and it's odd, or I don't know, funny is a good word for it, but how things, you know, come full circle sometimes. I grew up in Gainesville, but my mother's family is from this area, and we would come up to Mount Pleasant Baptist Church, and that's where James and Miss Bailey went to church for many years. And if we come up there, I'd go to Bible school up there with my cousins, and we'd be up there on several Sundays. We'd always go to church around my aunt. And Miss Bailey was one of those who taught me. Taught me in Sunday school, taught me in Bible school, and then I had the privilege of years later of trying to return a favor. I don't know how much I taught her, but being able to be the lady Sunday school teacher, that was her class for a while, and then the privilege of being her pastor for a while, you know, sort of works its way around, you know. She was an educator. She spent many years being an educator. There's many of women, and there's many men who look better today because she taught people how to dress hair and how to take care of them, make them look pretty. There's probably some in this room that she taught how to do that. But I know there's different ones in here that she taught different things just by her life. I remember the first year I pastored, or it might have been the same, I don't remember, we was doing Bible school, after the first night, she came up to me quietly and she said, "Now when you do the pledges, you need to do attention, salute, pledge." Well, all I did, I said, "Let's say the Pledge of Allegiance." Now, very sweet. She wanted to make sure the educator that I did it the proper way. And she was good about that. You know, she was reading in Titus chapter 2. It says in verse 3, it says, "The aged woman likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness, not false accusers, not given much wine, teachers of good things, that they may teach the young women to be sober, to love their husbands, and to love their children." You know, Miss Faye fit that right there. She taught y'all. And she may not have taught you verbally. She might not have said, "This is how you love your husband," or "This is how you raise your children." She might not have taught you that. But she taught it to you in the way that she lived her life. You know, she wasn't a lady who was easily intimidated, even though she was small in stature. I remember that when we had Ricky and Geraldine and Ricky here, little ventriloquist done. He had her stand up and he called her short and sweet. She was sweet and low. That's what it was, sweet and low. And that's a lot of truth for that. And of course, she thought it was funny. But you know, she wasn't afraid to step out and try new things. I remember she was part of a clown ministry at one time. She wasn't afraid to put on the clown suit, to act like a clown, but she did it for a reason. There was a purpose that she did. And that purpose was to bring a little bit of joy, put a smile on somebody's face, and to minister the children and adults alike. You know, there's not a lot of people today that will humble themselves and put on the clown suit and act goofy to minister to people. But she did. She wasn't afraid to try those new things. You know, at the RV park over there, that was her mission field. There's been many people who passed through this church who she invited to come to church here. There's some sitting back there who come to church here because she brought them to church here and they've been here for years. that was her mission field. She got out and she witnessed to them and she invited them to church. She let them know who she was. You know, there's a passage that I like from 2 Timothy right here that it says a lot, a few words. I'm going to read what Paul is telling Timothy. And this is a letter that Paul has wrote to Timothy. And we only have one side of this letter. Okay? We don't have both sides. It says, Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, and the will of God, according to the promise of life, which is in Christ Jesus, to Timothy, my beloved son, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord. I thank God, who I serve for my forefathers with pure conscience, that without ceasing I have remembrance of thee in my prayers, night and day. Greatly desiring seeing thee, being mindful of thy tears, that I may be filled with joy. When I call to remembrance the unfringed or sincere faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and thy mother Eunice, and I am persuaded that in thee also. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance, that thou stir up the gift of God which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord. You know, when you read through this, Paul acknowledges to Timothy right here that he knows that Timothy is brokenhearted for some reason. Timothy's crying. It could possibly be, and we don't know, that Timothy was upset for the same reason that we shed tears this week. Maybe he lost his mother and his grandmother. We don't know. Maybe he's going through a tough time. We don't know what his tears were being shed for. But we do know what Paul told him. Paul told him down there in verse 7, he said, for God has not given us a spirit of fear. You know, you're going into a new season of your life. Whether you're a friend here today or a family member or a child, you're going through a new season of your life, and that season is you're going to have to navigate it without Miss Faith. She's not here. She's not going to be here to help you navigate. But I want you to think about it. He said, God's not given us a spirit of fear. So if God didn't give us his spirit of fear, where'd it come from? Come from the other side. Okay? But this is what God has given us. He's given us a spirit of power. To stand up, to have the faith in troubled times, in hard times. He's given us that strength that if we'll trust in him, that we'll lean on him, that we have the power to cope with whatever this world brings us, whatever this life brings us. He's given us that. He's given us the spirit of a sound mind. To have discipline, self-control, to not be wavered back and forth like James talked about a double-minded man, to know what we believe and to know what it says. Miss Faye had that sound mind. She knew what the Word said and she stuck on that Word. And God gives us that spirit of that. We can also do the same thing. He also gave us a spirit of love. To love those that maybe sometimes might be difficult, the unlovable. I heard one time somebody say that Miss Faye didn't say no bad people. She thought all people was good. There's a lot of truth to that. She chose to say the good in everybody. A lot of times we choose to see the bad in everybody, don't we? But Miss Faye didn't do that. She chose to see the good in everybody. She chose to love the unlovable at times. And here's the thing. We have that same spirit that dwells inside of us if we accept Christ as our Savior. We can choose to do those things. But if we choose to live our life in fear, you'll never love, You'll never have a sound mind, and you'll never have the strength that God has granted you if you choose to live your life in fear. So the question is, well, how do we not live our life in fear when everything's crumbling around us? When times are hard? Notice what Paul, he gives Timothy the answer in verses 5 and 6. He says, when I call to remembrance the sincere faith that is in you, which dwelt first in your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice. Now you can change those words right there, and I can look at you today and I can say, I'm going to put you in remembrance of the faith that was in this faith. And if you remember when you go through hard times or tough times or when you have times of sorrow and you just don't know if you can make it, if you remember back and say, this is what Mama did. This is how Mama handled it. This is how Grandma handled it. This is what Mama did. We can have that strength. We can overcome fear. Miss Bowles is an overcomer. And you and I can be overcomers too. The Bible says that in 1 John that who are those who overcome the world? Those who believe in Jesus Christ as their Savior. We have that within us too. But when times are tough, when times are hard, he told Timothy to remember back. I'd encourage you, when times seem tough, when times seem hard, when fear sets in, no matter what the situation, remember back. Remember back when Miss Faye was faced with some things and how she dealt with it. She put her trust and her faith in Jesus Christ and said, it'll be okay. And it will be. And that's what I encourage you to do today. I encourage you to look and remember, and I wrote down a few things, what Miss Faye did, how she lived her life, the faith that she had and professed, and because she overcome, we can overcome. And in one day, as Paul said in this letter, we can do this, and I believe that this is fitting for Miss Faye, because she finished. Okay. Paul said, for I am now ready to be offered, and my time of departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. Miss Faye fought a good fight. She finished her course. She kept the faith. Since I have kept the faith, she did also. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. You see, that's a promise from Miss Faith. That was a promise from Paul, for Timothy, and that's a promise from you and I today. We hope, of course. She finished well. She, from time to time, when we leave on Sunday morning, she'd come by and she'd shake my hand. And some Sunday mornings, she'd give me a grade. Being an educator, she'd give me a grade on my sermon after. Sometimes she'd say, well, I give you an A today. Sometimes she'd say, well, I give you A+ today. Sometimes she would just say, I'm praying for you. Sometimes she would say, God bless you. Maybe those are my D's, my F's. But she always encouraged me. She encouraged others. I mean, you can go on and on about how she wanted to educate people. There's a library back here that she wanted to put printed material in people's hands so that they could read and that they could learn more. She's all about education. Today, as we go, I have to give Miss Faye an A+ on the way that she led her life. She did a good job. She loved everybody. She tried to take care of everybody. She tried to love those people and see the good in them instead of seeing the bad. that's something that that we need to mend. So family, I know that you love her, and she loved you. I love her. You look around, everybody in this room loves her. I appreciate it. And she loved her. Don't think for an instance that that love has gone anywhere. It hasn't changed. It's still there. In 1 Corinthians chapter 13, what we call the love chapter, the Bible tells us all the things that love is. Love's kind, you know, and all. You go through the whole list. You know. A lot of people have them on their walls of what love is. And it goes on down. It says, these things will fail. And it gives you a list of things that won't last and that they will fail. But it says that love will never fail. That love that she had for you, she still has it in heaven. The love that you have for her, it ain't gone nowhere. It's gone. So be encouraged by that. Know that she will. And this is my prayer for you today. As Paul told the Ephesian church, he said, be careful for nothing. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. When you go through tough times, do not miss faith. Look to Jesus. Pray about it. Tell God what you need. He already knows it. He just wants you to tell him sometimes. Okay? He wants you to talk it out with him. Tell him you're hurt. Some people say, well, you know, you can't question God. Well, they have not read the Psalms. Because David questioned God a lot of times in a lot of Psalms. He said, I don't understand this. And we can do the same thing. But God wants us to talk it out with him. And I encourage you to do that. And if we do, this is what will happen. It says, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Let's pray. Lord, again, once again, we come to you humbly as we can, thanking you for the salvation that you brought in this world, that we can stand up at times like this, and even though our hearts are heavy and our burdens are heavy, Lord, we shed tears and we mourn the loss. But Lord, we have the joy and the peace that through salvation, through you, that we do have everlasting life. Lord, we're thankful for Miss Faye and the witness that she led before us. Lord, I pray that you'll help us remember her and to live our lives a little more like what she did. Lord, I pray for this family. I pray that you'll lift them up, that you'll bless them, that you'll give them strength. And Lord, we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.